it's important you know certain regulations and ethics you need to observe in reporting election activities. It's very paramount. Now, what are you supposed to do, or what is your task or your role in enhancing or doing this effectively? You need to give accurate, and I emphasize that, accurate reportage of all activities that you will come across during the election day. You need to be concise. What exactly is the matter in which you are reporting? You need to avoid sensationalism, like things that will catch the eye of the generality of the Ghanaian public. You need to avoid this as media personnel. You also need to cross-check your facts with the election management bodies, that is Electoral Commission. It's not very paramount you note this point. Whatever you want to report, if you're not sure, or you have a bit of doubt, or for accuracy purposes, you need to consult with the authority which executes this election, and that is the election management body. In our Ghanaian parlance, we call it Electoral Commission. Be at the constituency level, at the regional level, wherever you find yourself, it's very important you observe and act decisively on this very point. There's no point to rush to publish an information on the proviso that I was the first media house to do so. Most of you, or some of you, are fond of doing that. I'm the first who have given this reportage on this issue, so that people will continue to express faith in your media house. It is good you are able to decipher information and get it reported on time. But in so doing, please, it's not a matter of who reports first. It's a matter of who gives the accurate information to avoid this attendant consequences if it is not a good reportage, or if it is full of malice and untruths and other things. And now, you don't have to rush to give a reportage. And having said that, you need to know a bit of our system, how we operate on election day. On election day, we have three important venues. The media will be required to observe the processes at three main events: polling stations, collation center at the constituency, and the collation center at the regional level. These three constitute the most important events which the media can partake in on 7th December. So on the police station, you are supposed to see the presiding officer, verification officer, name reference list officer, ballot issue. These are the five categories of people who will be working on the election day. So you know the role of the presiding officer, he's in charge. The NRO or the name reference list officer oversees the register and ensures that a voter who comes to the center's name is on the register before he or she refers the person to the VO, the verification officer, who administers the person to ensure that he or she goes through that process and allow him or her to go and register. You need to know the role of all these people. So at the polling center, you have the presiding officer, the name reference list officer, the verification officer, and the ballot issuers, because the PO will be in charge at the center. And at the very center, you expect to see security agents. Of course, they are to help maintain law and order, but they are not in charge at the police station. So if you have any observation, or if you go to the center and you want to report anything, report to the PO. If it's, even if it's a security issue, you have to talk to your PO first, who will confer with the security if there has been any security issue at the center. Don't just go straight to the police center and consult with a security because you deem the matter to be a security issue. First talk to the PO, because he or she is in charge. And whatever goes on at the center, he or she will be known. If it's a security issue, the security personnel over there will brief him or her as to what exactly has taken place. So to go to the center, the very person you have to consult with is the presiding officer, who will give you accurate happenings at the center. And of course, we have to get party agents there. Agents of parties are supposed to be center to observe. Now, the collation center, media houses should be allowed, political parties, agents should be allowed, and candidate agents will also be allowed at the collation center. And what we do at the collation center is to aggregate or collate all the results from the various polling stations. For example, Sunyani East Municipal, Sunyani Municipal has 258 polling stations. Until we get the results from all these 258 polling stations, the return officer, who is by law mandated to declare the results, cannot declare the results for the parliamentary. So if you are reporting, ask the return officer in charge, have you been able to get all the results from the 258 polling stations? So when you get to the center at the collation, ask the number of polling stations for that very constituency. So if you are conversant with this, then you'll be able to know that at this point in time, all the polling station results have come. So you can be on your own and say, this is what the results is. Now, us, media houses, you don't have the power to declare results. You don't have the power to declare results. I must emphasize this very point. You can announce. So the difference between the announcement and declaration is very simple. When you announce, you are only telling the general public what the figures are in respect of every candidate's votes. That's an announcement. For example, presidential, you have number one. So if you say number one obtained 600 votes, indeed you are announcing the results. Number two obtained 800 votes. So at the center, constituency center, for the parliamentary, you can state the number of votes obtained by each candidate, but the power to declare resides in the returning officer. So not until the returning officer states that having collated or having had submission or aggregating all the police station results, this is the final results. Until we get to that point, don't rush into your media. Even if you have the figures, and then the figures you have postlist that maybe candidate A has gotten more votes, you don't have the power to declare. Wait until the EC does that. That is the power of a good media business, reporting as it should be. So report as it is, don't declare. Always announce. It's only after the declaration, then when you are called upon, and so per the EC's declaration, such and such candidate won the parliamentary election. But for the presidential, we only announce the returning officer at the constituency, after having the power to declare the results for the parliamentary. For the parliamentary, we can say you have won. But for presidential, the returning officer only mentions the results of that. And now when you go to the collation center, there are two collation officers. We have constituency collation officer, which is, this time we have two terminologies. We have constituency collation officer, who is the returning officer for that constituency. And we have collation officer for the constituency. We have recruited people who will be entered the results on the computer and will display on the projected screen. So we call them collation officer, but the actual constituency collation officer is the returning officer. So know the difference. So when you go, don't talk to the one entering the figures on the electronic whatever, talk to the returning officer. Of course, this officer will be there to assist. So in all your reportage at the center, talk to the returning officer or the DEO. When it comes to the regional level, it's the same thing. So the returning officer will declare the results at the constituency for the parliamentary and announce only the presidential. When it comes to the regional level, where I will preside or I will act as the collation officer, I will be the regional collation officer for the presidential results. I emphasize, I will be the regional collation officer by virtue of my position as the regional director for the presidential results. Meaning that I'm only going to announce. So I receive all the results for the presidential, for the parliamentary to be declared at the council level. So for the parliamentary, they only bring the results there from that angle. But for presidential, they will bring all the results, and then I will aggregate them, or I will give a summation, or I will just collate them, and then announce the votes obtained by each of the 12 candidates. So at the regional level, I don't have the power even to declare the winner of the presidential as far as Bono region is concerned. I will only announce candidates number one obtained this, number two obtained this, three up to the last person. So please note that at the regional level, we will do the announcement and then we take it from there. And after all this, the commission has a meeting of the EC. And then we will, what we have, we need to fax, what you have to send in hard copies to the EC, we have it with that Monday. So on this note, I'll just urge the media, you have been very, very supportive since I came here 2 years ago in my course or in my discourse as regional electoral director of electoral commission. And I continue to cherish you. But for this election, let us all work together by ensuring that we do our role as a part of them, as part of us, with art, conciseness, honesty, and a good reportage. I wish you all the best.